We're going to illustrate this with a very simple example, and here it is. So imagine you've got a robot that just has two things, okay? It is a map of a hallway, okay? So here you're seeing a hallway. And by the way, this little blue dot here, this is the robot. The robot doesn't actually know where it is. We know where it is because we're really, really smart, okay? Or we work for the NSA. I hope that didn't cost me my grant. Anyway, so the robot knows this map, and it knows essentially where the walls are and where the doors are. And we'll assume that the doors are open, right? The other thing that the robot has is it just has a detector, a sensor, really dumb, that just looks out to the side. You can even think of it as it's just got a stick, and it pokes it. And it says, do I hit something or don't I? And by the way, it's not very accurate. So he sticks it out there, and sometimes he sticks it this way, and sometimes he sticks. So it's approximately that direction. He just says, did I hit something or not? Now, you might think that would be an incredibly dumb robot. And you might be right, except here's a picture of a robot. I don't want to insult my SRI friends, because this robot actually got pretty smart. But this is the robot originally Flaky here. And Flaky had down below on the bottom these little ultrasonic sensors that would send out a chirp, and it would respond back, did I hit anything? Or how far away was the thing that I hit? So humor me that this is just a robot that basically detects just a hole or just a not a hole. That's the only thing that it knows. And because it's not perfect in setting out its signal, right, just because the sensor says hole doesn't mean it actually was a hole, right? And just because it says wall doesn't mean it actually was a wall, okay?